Good morning everyone. Today I am going to discuss the aromaticity under chapter atomic and molecular structure. So some examples of aromatic compound, anti-aromatic compounds, and also talk about the aniline, 14 and 18 aniline. Okay. So in the previous video lecture I have discussed aromatic compound, anti-aromatic compound, non-aromatic compound with their examples and criteria. So now come to 14 aniline. So 14 aniline, planar geometry required for aromaticity destabilized by van der Waals repulsions between indicated hydrogens. So these four hydrogen atoms are very close to each other. What will happen? They feel or experience repulsions. So it experiences repulsions due to four hydrogens close to each other, resulting higher energy. So flat structure gets converted, and there will be 1D, by mistake it has been written double D, to tilt structure, that is non-planar. Except planarity, it obeys all criteria, so it is non-aromatic compound. So its planarity has been lost. Why? Due to the presence of repulsions experience exerted by four adjacent hydrogen atoms, they are very much close to each other. So that's why their flat structure gets tilt. Okay. So planar geometry required for aromaticity destabilized by van der Waals repulsion between indicated hydrogen. Okay. So that's why 14 aniline is non-aromatic compound, but 18 aniline also it is aromatic compound. Why? Here also 6 hydrogen atom, but it should have non-planar structure, but these 6 hydrogen atoms are far away from each other. That's why they didn't experience any repulsions. So no serious repulsions among 6 interior hydrogens. Molecule is planar and aromatic. So why these interior 6 hydrogen atoms do not feel any repulsions among them due to far away from each other. Okay. So that's why 18 aniline is the planar and it's also aromatic compounds. Okay. Now some example of aromatic compound which is not discussed previous lecture. So first one here, cyclobut-3-in-1-2-diene. Okay. So here n equals to 1. Okay. Compound 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So what will happen here? Here this is the sp3, this is also sp3. Because negative charge means 2 electron, 2 electron means 1 pi. As I told you in the previous video lectures. So negative charge means 2 electron, that is 1 pi. So sp3. Okay. So this negative charge can be delocalized through conjugations. Okay. So this compound, this is the compound 1. In case of compound 2, this lone pair also acts as a 1 pi electron. So 1 pi, 1 pi, 3 pi. So n equals to 6, that is 6 pi. Okay. Here n equals to 1, here n equals to also 1. Okay, so you know 4n plus pi 2 system n equals to the 6 pi electron, 2 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi, 6 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi, this lone pair, consider as 1 pi electrons, okay, 4 hydrogen of iron, 4 electrons. Similarly here, 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, this negative charge also acts as a pi electron, okay, so n equals to 1, so n equals to here 1, 6 pi electrons, here n equals to 1, 6 pi electrons, here n equals to 1, 6 pi electrons. Here n equals to 1, it also 6 pi electrons. Why? 1 pi, 1 pi, 1 pi. This lone pair also acts as 1 pi electron. Okay. Here n equals to 1, 1 pi, 1 pi. This lone pair also acts as 1 pi lone pair electrons. Okay. So 1 pi, 1 pi, 6 pi electron system. Okay. Now here n equals to 1, so 1 pi, 1 pi, and this works. Lone pair of electron on oxygen atom also 1 pi, that is 6 pi electron. Okay. Here also 1 pi, 1 pi, 1 pi, that is n equals to 1. So all the molecules that I have written here, all follows Haeckel's 4n plus 2 pi electron system, n equals to 1, that is 6 pi electron system. Okay. And all the molecules are cyclic, okay. All the molecules are planar. What about sp3? Here sp3 can be converted into sp2 through what? Through delocalization, as delocalization due to conjugations. This comes, this comes. So only this sp3 is can be converted to sp2 easily. Okay. So cyclic, planar, obey Haeckel's rules. Okay. So all the above compounds from 1 to 7 follow Haeckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electrons, cyclic and planar, delocalization of pi electrons in conjugated system. Okay. All are aromatic. In case of compound 1, conversion of sp3 to sp2 is possible due to delocalization of pi electrons. Okay. So that's why these are the aromatic compounds. What about the anti-aromatic compounds? Here compound 1, 2, 3, 4. Here n equals to 1, anti-aromatic means 4n pi, n equals to 1, 4n pi, 4 pi electron system. Here equals to n equals to 2, 4 pi electron system. Here n equals to 2, why? 1 pi, 1 pi, this lone pair also acts as 1 pi, so n equals to 2, so 4 into 2, that is 8 pi electron system. This is also n equals to 1, that is 4 pi electron system. So all the above compounds from 1 to 4, follow Haeckel's rule, 4n pi electrons. They are cyclic, no questions, and planar. Okay, there is a no question of sp3 hybridizations, so there is a no question of non-planarity, so all the molecules are planar. Okay, and pi electrons, delocalization of pi electron in conjugated system. Okay, comes here. Okay, all our compounds are anti-aromatic compounds. Okay. So these are compounds of aromatic and anti-aromatic compounds. Next, move on. Non-aromatic compounds. Here 1, 2, 3 compounds. Here n equals to 0. N0 cyclobutene. N equals to 0 means 2 pi electron system. It follows 4n plus 2 pi electron system. When you talk about the non-aromatic compounds, we should examine 4n plus 2 pi electron system and also 4n pi electron system. We should check whether it anti-aromatic or aromatic. Okay. Through this Haeckel's formula, 4n plus 2 pi and 4n pi. Here, n equals to 1. N equals to 1, that is 4n pi electron system. Okay. So 4n pi electron system, 4 pi, 1 pi, 2 pi, so this lone pair acts as a pi, so total 4 pi, n equals to 1, 4 pi electrons. Okay. Here 1, 2, 3, n equals to 1, it also follows for Haeckel's 4n plus 2 pi electron system. Clear? So in terms of Haeckel's rule, all the three compounds obey Haeckel's rules. 1 and 3 obeys Haeckel's rules, 4n plus 2 pi electron system, and compound 2 obeys Haeckel's rule, 4n pi electron system. Okay, so all the compounds follows the Haeckel's rule, but question arises in terms of hybridization, and also all the molecules are cyclic, there will be no problem. So all the molecules cyclic obey Haeckel's rule, both 4n plus 2 pi and 4n pi, that is aromatic, chances of aromatic and anti-aromatic. But when you talk about the planarity, during the examination of planarity, we should check the hybridization. Oh, here sp3. So in case of compound 1, this sp3 cannot be converted into sp2 due to lack of conjugations. So here planarity has been lost. Here sp3 cannot be converted into sp2, planarity in loss. Here sp3 cannot be converted into sp2 due to lack of conjugation. There is no conjugation, negative charge lone pairs. So all the three molecules 1, 2, 3 has no planar structure. Their planarity has been lost due to sp3 hybridizations, and these sp3 hybridizations cannot be converted to sp2 due to lack of conjugation. So that's why only for sp3 hybridizations all these three molecules are non-aromatic compounds. Okay, although these three compounds, cyclic, Obel-Haeckel rules, both 4n plus 2 pi and 4n pi, but due to the question of planarity, they failed to prove that planarity, that's why they are non-aromatic compounds. So, compound 1 and 3 should be aromatic as it follows Haeckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electron, they are cyclic, but they are non-aromatic as non-planarity arises due to sp3 hybridization and no chance to convert to sp2 due to lack of conjugations. But in case of compound 2, it should be anti-aromatic as it follows Haeckel rules 4 and 5. But due to non-planarity of sp3 hybridizations, which is not converted to sp3 due to lack of conjugations, same explanation. So due to lack of conjugations, sp3 hybridizations cannot be converted into sp2. So that's why they are acting as a non-aromatic compounds. Okay. Now the difference between aromatic, anti-aromatic, or non-aromatic, or you can say the main criteria. Aromatic and anti-aromatic, we differentiate compared to compounds, aromatic and anti-aromatic compounds. So both the case 1, 2, 3, planar, planar, cyclic, cyclic, or ring structures, delocalization of pi electron in conjugated system, delocalization of pi electron in conjugation system. So up to 3, the common features, common criteria, both aromatic and anti-aromatic compounds. So of course, number 4 features or criteria, Obel-Haeckel's rule, 4n plus 2. If compound follows 4n plus 2 pi electron system, then it should be called aromatic compound. If compound obeys 4n plus 4n pi electron system, then it is called anti-aromatic compound. Okay, now what will be the non-aromatic compound? If any one criterion does not follow, then it is non-aromatic compound. So out of 3, if any one is not maintained, as you see here, everything is fine in terms of aromatic and anti-aromatic. Due to the planarity, question of planarity, all the three compounds are acting as a non-aromatic compounds. Clear? So that is the main criteria of aromatic, anti-aromatic, or non-aromatic compounds. So you can say differentiation. Now the homoaromaticity. It is a special case of aromaticity in which conjugation is interrupted by a single sp3 hybridized carbon atom. It is a special case of aromaticity in which conjugation is interrupted by a single sp3 hybridized carbon atom, or a compound that contains one or more sp3 hybridized atom. So it is a special case of aromaticity in which conjugation is interrupted by a single sp3 hybridized. If there is a sp3 hybridized, conjugation is interrupted. Simply, cyclooctatetraene, after taking H plus proton in presence of compound H2SO4, what will happen? You see, there is a positive charge because this pi electron take up the protons. So there is a, now this carbon becomes a sp3 hybridized. So now there is a lack of conjugations. So homotropylium cations, due to lack of conjugations, this acts as a homoaromaticity. So sp by single sp3 hybridized carbon atom or compound that contains one or more sp3 hybridized. If sp3 carbon arises, so this is the homoaromaticity. In terms of quasi aromaticity, quasi, it is aromatic compound which involves charge delocalization. Charge is present in the ring. A compound where positive or negative charge is a part of Haeckel's rule of aromaticity. So it is an aromatic compound which involves charge, positive charge or negative charge. Charge delocalization, charge is present in the ring, it should be positive or negative. So there is, if there is a charge, then you get the quasi aromaticity compounds. Okay. Take examples. Here, there is a positive charge, there is a positive charge, negative charge, negative charge. So these are the quasi-aromatic compound. There is a charge developed. Positive charge, negative charge, developed. Okay, if charge either positive or negative, then we get quasi-aromatic compound. Okay, but here you see it is a not quasi-aromatic as no charge is present. You see, but when it loses two protons from OH, what will happen? There is a negative charge developed on oxygen atom. Now this negative charge take part in the conjugations. Okay, so what will happen? There will be a double bond. This bond comes here. There will be negative charge. So there is a charge developed. So there is a charge species. So this charge on oxygen atom. So that is called quasi aromatic compound. Why not? Due to the charge on oxygen atom. Okay. So now all the quasi aromatic compounds are aromatic, but all aromatic compounds are not quasi aromatic compounds. Okay. So all quasi aromatic compound. All quasi aromatic compound. Are aromatic, but all aromatic compounds are not quasi aromatic compounds. So all quasi aromatic compounds are aromatic, but all aromatic compounds are not quasi aromatic compounds. Okay, you understood? Now stability. Stability order increasing. We know aromatic compound always more stable than homo aromatic compound, then non aromatic compound, then anti aromatic compound. Okay. So stability order increasing, aromatic compound will be more stable than homo aromatic, then non aromatic, then simply aromatic, greater than non aromatic, greater than anti aromatic. Okay, this is the order of stability increasing. Now question, or you can say application of aromaticity. Which is more basic of the following? Which is more basic of the following? You are given acetone, this one, 1 and 2 complex. Okay, here what will happen if this molecule accept protons? Protons through oxygen possesses lone pair heavy electron. Now this lone pair electron take up this proton. What will happen? Oxygen become plus. So plus charge developed on oxygen atoms. Okay, so it's plus 2. This is the compound 2. Okay. Now in compound 1, what will happen? If it accept protons, if it accept protons, then what will happen? Then it becomes OH plus, that is positive charge residing on oxygen atom. Okay. Now due to the presence of lone pair of electron on this benzene moiety, so this lone pair gets involved through conjugations, comes here, pi bonded shifted here, this double bond goes to carbon oxygen atoms. What will happen? This positive charge balance, so we get OH molecules, but O here oxygen possesses positive charge, so double bond pi electron system changes. So compound 1 is more basic than compound 2 due to aromatic character. Why? 6 pi electrons here, 1, 2, and this lone pair also acts as a pi electron. So 6 pi electron, planar structures, delocalizations through conjugation, so it is aromatic compound. So this is the aliphatic compound, acetone. This is the aromatic compound. So aromatic compound stability order will more in terms of basicity. Here, which one will be more basic? And this compound, compound 1, will be more basic due to its aromaticity character. Why? Because it follows the 6 pi electron system. Okay. N equals to 1, that is 6 pi, Haken's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electron systems, 1 pi, 1 pi, this lone pair also considered as a pi electron, so 6 pi electron, cyclic system, planar system, there is a conjugation, that is delocalization of electrons, so conjugations, so this is the aromatic compound. So that's why basicity of the compound 1 is more than compound 2 due to the aromatic character. Due to the aromatic character, that's why this is the aromatic compound, this is the aliphatic compound. Okay. Next, move on. Which is more basic of the following? There are three compounds A, B, C. Okay, this is very important. Which is more basic of the following? Or basicity or not? You see compound 1, A, B, C. So first we taking compound C. Compound C, here lone pair acts as a pi, also here acts as a sp3. Okay, this nitrogen acts as a sp3. Now, here lone pair of electron or nitrogen atom is not involved, so its basicity will be high. Why? This, there is a no pi bond, so there is a no question of delocalization of this lone pair of electron residing on nitrogen atom, so lone pair availability is high. This lone pair is not involved or engaged any conjugations, so that's why here this compound C acts as a more basic character. So here lone pair of electron or nitrogen atom is not involved, so its basicity will be high. Further, we know that sp3 hybridized system are more basic than sp2 system. So sp3 hybridized system are more basic than sp2 system. So compound C has more basic character than compound B and A. Okay. Now come to compound B. For compound B, compound B 1 pi, 1 pi, 1 pi. Lone pair acts as a pi. 6 pi electron, this is the aromatic compounds. When it take up photons, what will happen? N plus. Okay. So it loses its aromaticity. Now 4 pi electron system. So these molecules, after taking H plus ions, it loses its aromaticity. So it is aromatic compound. After taking H plus, what will happen? It becomes anti-aromatic compounds. Now here 2 pi, 2 pi. That is 4 pi electron, 1 pi, 1 pi, 2 pi, that is 4 pi electron system. So it loses its aromaticity after taking up a proton, that is conjugated acid is not stable in compound B. Okay. Now come to compound A. Compound A, 6 pi electron aromatic compound, 1, 2, 3, 6 pi electrons. Okay. Now question will arise. This lone pair of electron, why not consider as a pi electron? You consider here pi electron, you consider as a pi electron. Why not here? That will be discussed here. I will discuss later. If this take up H plus proton, what will happen? NH plus, what will happen? After proton taking up proton, it remains its aromaticity 6 pi, 1, 2, 3, 6 pi electrons. So after taking a proton, it does not lose its aromaticity. So it does not lose its aromaticity. So basic character will be C will be high than A than B. So B is the least basic, C is the highest basic. Why? Now C lone pair does not involve in the conjugations. So moreover, it is sp3. Sp3 hybridized system are more basic than sp2. And here aromatic before taking a proton, it is aromatic, 6 pi electron aromatic. After taking a proton, it is also aromatic. There is no question of loss of aromaticity. But compound B, after taking a proton, before taking proton, it is aromatic. After taking proton, it is anti-aromatic compound, so it loses its aromaticity. So that's why it is least basic. Okay. Now, here, this system. 4 pi electrons non-aromatic compound. Okay. Sp3 hybridized 1 pi, 1 pi, 2 pi, 4 pi electron system. If it loses H plus, non-aromatic. If it loses here, after taking H plus, it loses aromaticity. If it loses H plus, then it takes up or getting aromatic character. How? It H plus means it minus H plus means abstract H plus, that means there is a negative charge on carbon atom. What will happen? Now it is a 6 pi electron system, it is aromatic. This sp2, okay, now this is the sp3. So conjugative base is highly stable due to change in nature. CHA, there is a mistake of spelling, change in nature. Okay, so this is the 4 pi electron non aromatic compound. After losing proton, it becomes aromatic compound. Okay, similarly, here you see. There is a 5 ring member, there are two nitrogen atoms. Both nitrogen possess lone pair of electron. As I told you, this lone pair, why not consider as a pi electron? Here, lone pair of electron or nitrogen atom cannot take part in conjugation as there is a double bond on nitrogen atom. So, adjacent, there is a double bond and lone pair. If you get the adjacent nitrogen, more electronegative nitrogen oxygen, adjacent double bond, then lone pair electron cannot be considered as a pi electron. So if lone pair electron or more electronegative element like nitrogen oxygen and adjacent double bond present, then consider only double bond. So if more electronegative element like nitrogen and oxygen, okay, and their adjacent or vicinity there is a double bond and also more electronegative element for this lone pair, then you nullify or do not consider that lone pair of electron on that more electronegative element. When you count a pi electron, then you do not consider that pi lone pair electron on that more electronegative element like this. This is the nitrogen, okay, this is adjacent double bond, also possess lone pair of electron. This is nitrogen atom, adjacent double bond, also possess lone pair of electron. 1 pi, 1, 1, 2, 3 pi. If you consider lone, then 4 pi, that is 8 pi electron system is not possible. So, whenever the more electronegative nitrogen and oxygen possess lone pair of electron, you should check whether there is adjacent double bond. If double bond present adjacent more electronegative nitrogen and oxygen, then you do not consider that lone pair of electron during the counting of pi electron. Okay, so that's why I have mentioned here. If lone pair of electron and more electronegative element like nitrogen, oxygen and adjacent double bond present, then consider only double bond. Okay, no lone pair of electron. Next, very important, Craig's rule. So by the help of Craig's rule, we can identify the aromatic and non-aromatic character. Okay. So by the Craig's rule, we can identify the aromatic and non-aromatic character. What the rule states by Craig's? According to this rule, it is applied for polycyclic compound. So it is applicable for aromatic and non-aromatic character. That means if rule is applied to identify aromatic and non-aromatic compound. How will you understand if I say which one is aromatic and non-aromatic compounds? We can also apply Craig's rule. Besides the criteria of aromatic and non-aromatic criteria, so we can say the compounds aromatic and non-aromatic by the help of Craig's rule. Okay, this is also important. So first statement, rule 1, it is applied for polycyclic compound. Polycyclic means there are more than one ring. Okay, so it is applied for polycyclic compound. There are one more cyclic compound. It is applicable to non-benzoate compound. It is applicable for non-benzoate compound. It should not be benzoate, benzene ring. If there is a benzene ring, then it is not applicable. Okay, molecules should have C2 axis of symmetry, that is 180 degree, not C, it is 180 degree. So by mistake it has been written as a C, it is 180 degree. So everywhere it is written as a 180 degree. Okay, so actually it is 180 degree. So I have to check it, otherwise it will be confused. Sorry for interruption. sorry for interruption. So hot level molecular should have C2x of symmetry 180 degree. If number of double bond equals to what? Equals to aromatic compounds. That means if you get number of double bond equals to what, then you can say it is aromatic compound. If number of double bond equals to even, you can say it is a non-aromatic compound. Or rule number 4 can be written as n equals to number of double bond, we get two types of, if n minus 1 equals to what, non-aromatic compound, just reverse of this rule. If n minus 1 equals to even, that is aromatic compound. So Ruhart the Craig's rule say it is applied for polycyclic compound, it is applicable to non-benzoate compound. Molecules should have C2-axis of symmetry 180 degree. If number of double bond equals to 1, then you get aromatic compound. If number of double bond equals to even, then you get non-aromatic compound. Or rule number 4 can be written as n equals to number of double bond. If we have a n minus 1 equals to 1, then n minus 1 equals to what, then non-aromatic compound. Just reverse the rule number 4. If n minus 1 equals to even, then aromatic compound. Okay, pentylene. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So C2-axis 180 degree. We get the same molecule, that it has C2-axis of symmetry. So it is non-benzoate, there is no benzene ring. It is polycyclic compound, presents more than one cycle. So number of double bond equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, 4 means even, even means non-aromatic compounds. Okay. Or if you apply this rule, n minus n equals to 4, n minus 1 equals to 4 minus 1, 3. So n minus 1 equals to 3 means what? Odd means non-aromatic compound. In both the rule, 4 and this rule, we get the same molecules, non-aromatic compound. Okay. Similarly, in this case of azulene, so what will happen? C2-axis symmetry 180 degree. Okay. Pi electron shifted here, shifted here, shifted here. That is negative charge, positive charge. There is a dipole. So that's why it is a high dipole moment. So what will happen? It is also non-benzoate system. There is no benzene ring. It is polycyclic. Polycyclic has two cycle present. Number of double bond 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 5 means odd. Odd means aromatic compounds. Or n equals to 5. So 5 minus 1, that is 4. 4 means they are even. Even means aromatic compounds. So we have proved that in both rule number 4 or this rule, both the case, we have seen that the get the same type of compound, whether aromatic and non-aromatic compound. Again, I repeat this. In case of pentylene, you see this is the C2-axis of symmetry. So this is the non-benzoate. There is no benzene ring. Same molecule, C2-axis of symmetry. Polycyclic molecules, okay. Polycyclic, non-benzoate, C2-axis. Next, number of double bond, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, even, even, non-aromatic. You can remember either two rules or one, any one. So a non-aromatic compound. If you apply this rule, so n equals to 4, 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3 means what? What means non-aromatic compounds. Okay. When you talk about the azulene, what will happen? This is also polycyclic compound. Non-benzoate, there is no benzene ring. Okay. Then it applied C2-axis 180 degree. Okay. What will happen? Number of double bond 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5, 5 means odd, odd means aromatic compound. Or if you apply this rule, n minus 1, that is 5 minus 1, 4, 4 means even, even means aromatic compound. Okay, so in this way, by the help of Craig's rule, we can find out the aromatic compound and non-aromatic compound. So it is applicable for aromatic, non-aromatic compounds. I have explained details. So here the two examples, pentylenes and azulenes, I have also shown you here how to check out which one is aromatic and non-aromatic compounds. So rule number 4, there is a two option. You can remember either two rules or you can any one, then you can find out the which one is aromatic compound and non-aromatic compound. This rule valid for non-benzoate system, also applicable for polycyclic compound, also should have C2-axis of symmetry. Then you come the number of double bonds. If number of double bonds are aromatic compounds, if number of double bonds even, then non-aromatic compounds. Or if you apply this n-1 formula, equals to even aromatic compound, n minus 1 equals to 1, then non-aromatic compounds. So I have finished the aromaticity chapter. So I hope you are enjoying this video. Thanks for watching this video.